Hi, my name is Franco Rotoli, and I'm a learning experience expert on the SOLIDWORKS training team. Today, I'm going to show you how to take advantage of Pack and Go. This SOLIDWORKS staple has been around for a long time and has grown to meet the needs of anyone wanting to share or back up their designs offline. Let's jump over to SOLIDWORKS and get started. I have this assembly of a 3D printable toy quadcopter. If I look at all the reference components through the File References menu, I see there are quite a few files here, and they are scattered throughout a few different folders. To function properly, SOLIDWORKS assemblies need to know where all the components are located and have access to them when opened. If I send just the assembly file to someone outside my organization that doesn't have access to all the parts, they won't be able to work with my assembly. Also, if I need to move the assembly and/or its files to a different location on my hard drive or network, simply dragging and dropping can cause references to break. There has to be a better way. This is why we have Pack and Go. From the main assembly, I'll go to the File menu and choose Pack and Go. This finds all the referenced parts of my assembly and lists them out. At the top of the dialog, I can choose to include other reference files like drawings, toolbox components, simulation results, and others. And starting with SOLIDWORKS 2024, I can even save the files as an earlier version of SOLIDWORKS. As I change my selections up top, Pack and Go keeps a running count of how many files of each type I'm dealing with. Down here, I can choose to move the files to a new folder or zip them up in a neat little package. Before I do that, I want to look at a couple of additional options I have below. I can add a prefix or suffix to every file before copying. This will help distinguish the new files from the old ones. I can also change the folder structure to a single folder, keep the same folder structure, or simplify the folders to something more reasonable. I typically choose one of the top two. I'll add my initials to the front of every file as a prefix. When I hit enter, it shows me a preview of all the new file names and where they will be saved. For simplicity's sake, I'll just create a subfolder named New and put everything in there. Clicking Save will bring up a progress bar at the bottom, create all those new files, and update all the file references. Opening up the new assembly, we can see that all the files have been renamed. When I go into the File References window, we can see all the files and all the paths are consistent with my Pack and Go settings. And most importantly, when I opened this new assembly, I didn't get any file location errors. I can now work on this copy of the assembly without worrying about messing up the original. Of course, a better way to manage my data would be to use a data management system like SOLIDWORKS PDM or the 3D Experience platform, but we'll save that for another video. Thanks for watching this video. If you found the information here helpful, click on the link in the description below where we have more tips, tricks, and training courses. And as always, happy designing!